What's going on, coaches? Hey, let me ask you something. Did you watch the Mississippi State versus Auburn game this Saturday? You probably didn't. You're probably watching something like the Michigan-Penn State, who, by the way, do you know what play Michigan went up with? Huh? It was mesh. Or you're watching something else, probably doing your honey-do list. But in today's video, what I want to talk about are some of the takeaways that I got from watching the Mississippi State game, where Coach Leach scored 40 unanswered points in the second quarter to actually beat, I think he went up again on the biggest comeback in Mississippi State history. All right, so if you're here, drop a thumbs, a like it and everything like that, and tell me where you're from, because guys, I had a blast. Now, to get into this, first off, FUXO Digital, because I know you were going to put something on this, a copyright strike or something like that, so I hope you, when you get in bed, you fart and you don't trust that. You do trust that fart and you shit the bed, because I do not like you at all. And now with that out of the way, let's go, baby. I freaking loved this game. I watched it all the time, and we are going the magnificent Mike Leach. Look, let's get this out of the way, okay? We know that Mississippi State is not going to freaking win any national championships yet, but we can say that they are very competitive with the air raid. I don't understand the hate when people say, hey, but he can't win the national championship. No shit. I'm sorry. Let's call a spade a spade. It's between Georgia and Alabama right now. I mean, good Lord, can we not appreciate in year two, his very first full year in this offense, he's got these boys beating Texas A&M, Kentucky, Auburn, and I'm sure there's someone else I'm totally forgetting. They are competing. They are winning. He is magnificent. So let's freaking dive into this. But, you know, people always say, oh, Coach Mackey, coaches, everybody, the air raid can't work in the SEC. I say baloney on that. Look at this, okay? The craziest thing, my boy, Drew Piscopo, you know he went down there. He's gone to two games now and watched live in person. And he is talking about Will Rogers, who is destroying. He has like an 80%, 70% completion percentage in the SEC when everybody knows what they are doing. That is the beautiful thing about this offense, all right? He's had 300 over every SEC opponent. Unfreaking believable. And I want you to look over here. Let me go ahead and get my ugly face out of the way. Look at this, all right? So the passing, I don't even know, first downs. Who gives a crap? I want to come down here to passing. Look at this. 412 completions out of 546 attempts. They have touchdowns, 30. This is freaking insane, the total amount of plays and everything like that. And, you know, since I'm a part-time math teacher, I'm going to break it down. So the completion percentage is 75%. They're completing 75% of the passes, which is unbelievable, which is what you have to do in this offense. This is not a throw-deep type of offense. This is a dink and dunk, long handoffs to the flats and stuff like that. And we're going to cover it in some of these cut-ups. That is what happens. So the interceptions per attempt is one out of every 100. So every 100 throws, you're going to have one interception. Okay, that's to you, you know, TBHs, tight butthole coaches, you're probably like, F that, man. That is awful. I can't live with that. I want to hand the ball off 1,000 times. Let's bring in 13 personnel and all that stuff. No, that is unbelievable. Touchdowns per attempt, 5%. So that means you throw the ball 20 times, you're going to score one of those. Everybody and their brother would love to have those stats, all right? But you're not going to get those because, again, TBH, the buttholes, they're so tight. So with stats like that, though, honestly, why would you want to run the ball? I mean, you're passing it is more efficient. You're moving the ball. You're getting everybody involved, both the wide receivers and the running back. It opens up the run game. So when you actually do run the ball, you've got massive holes and lanes and everything like that. Why would you do it like Russ? All right. So what I'm going to do, and I'm going to pull up right here. I'm going to go through some of the plays that stood out to me. Okay. I don't know him personally, like Drew Piscopo and all that, the calls and everything, but watching the game, I was like, oh crap, that's a great play and everything like that. So while I'm doing that, I appreciate everybody here. Tony, what's going on? Coach Clayton, how are you doing, sir? Brandon, what's going on from Ohio? AB pump for this one. Me too, man. I'm glad I made it. I'm surprised I didn't fall asleep. Steve, what's going on? Did you watch this Spider-Man one? That was freaking unbelievable, the trailer. If you haven't already, after you watch this video, go watch the Spider-Man video. It was unbelievable. Colby, I'm from Starkville, Mississippi. Love Coach Leach. Been following you for the other Leach videos you made. Keep up the good work. Thank you very much, sir. Hey, XO, they're awful, man. They are awful. It works because Bama runs air raid concepts. Ole Miss does. Yeah, so I never understood the statement. I completely agree. Anthony, what's going on, buddy? How you doing? All right, so we're going to get into the play. So the very first one, fourth and one, okay? And usually what do coaches do? Coaches in the fourth and one situation, and Coach Leach has done this a couple of times. They get the TBH. We all get the TBH, but not this time. What he does is he lines up in late. He runs a scissors concept or a switch concept, and I've got film. I'm going to show this in a minute. He pushes the running back, and what he does is when he pushes the running back, this causes a slight delay, and he opens up the lane right here for this play. So let me go ahead and bring it up. So look, we got 3-by-1, all right? You're going to motion this guy right here, this running back. Let me do this. Let me get this out of the way. He's motioning the running back. This causes him to hesitate just a minute. Number three in here is going to hit up a nice little hitch. Boom. Look at that. Look at the grass. Rodgers is looking at him right now. His eyes are on him. Eyes are on him. Eyes are on him. Eyes. Look at this. Everybody's eyes are on somebody. He finds the grass. Nice, simple completion on fourth and one. Be honest. How many times are you calling a pass play on fourth and one? Well, don't, because what do you think other teams are going to be doing? They're going to think, holy crap, this is going to be a run, so we're going to stack the box. But if you have that one play, whatever it is, stick, a corner, a quick screen or something like that, you're attacking grass, you're going to be difficult to defend on the fourth down, all right? So that was the very first thing that popped out, like, oh, Leach's got a big boy balls on, you know? Because usually he does his inside zone, but he decided not to on this one, and kudos, right? Kudos. The second one. This is one. I don't know how many of y'all follow me or anything like that. I love two-back motion. This would be green tear right there because you're tearing the running back across the formation. And this is great because what he does is it makes it look like he's blocking. It's a play-action fake. Now, the Y is pass setting or blocking like he's blocking for the bubble. And then he hits it with the slant. And if you have, you know, the locks, and I'll show that he actually did one of those, is good. But this play right here, fellas, this play is something sexy, man. So you're going push motion. Watch this guy right here, number two in the slot. This is green tear, how I call it. So boom, look, Will, I'm like I'm a first name basis, is keying this man. You can see his eyes are on this cat right here. Look, what does he do? He goes out because they run this motion so much. This pulls this linebacker out to cover the flats. And then look what happens. The play fake gets this linebacker to suck up just a little bit. Even when you do it just a little bit, it is unbelievable. Look, fake it, boom, right there. Right now, this is a key coaching point that is very difficult to do. Watch how he hesitates. He hesitates just a second to clear this linebacker, number nine. That is something that's difficult for your quarterback to do because what he'll want to do if you call this, he wants to hold it and then throw it right now. And he could probably hit nine in the head and it's a pick six. But if you hold it just a second, wait for that wide receiver to get behind him, good things happen. I mean, this is just nasty. This is just nasty. Also, look at watch the quarterback's shoulder pads. Look how he looks this way. Eyes are here, shoulders are here. You know, Mouse Davis always says to quarterbacks, the best thing you can have, large eyes, so you can put the defense where he goes. Look when he looks this way, where everybody's going, and then he quit. Look, got him. They're doing some kind of cat coverage on top. I did piss on it. Boom, right there. I love this play. This is something if you have two backs, you've got to put in on top of the locks because defenses are going to jump that slant all the freaking time, baby. I love it. All right, the next one. Talking about locks, this was a great call, and this is the takeaway from this call. He called this play when it was in the red zone. Usually, what do you do when you're calling a lock play? You're usually calling it third down, maybe second down in the open field or backed up. You're hardly ever running this when you're close to your to scoring. And what I like about this is because this takes kahunas. This is something that you're like, hey, I'm in the number 17 team in the nation's home field advantage. The crowd's going loud. We're down. They score 28 straight points. It's 28-3, 28-17 or something like that. We need to just go ahead and just YOLO it. And that is what Coach Leach does here. And it's a beautiful thing because, again, look, second and two inside the 20 or on the 20. Okay, look at this. Really sells it. Really sells it. Do you see that? You see the ball right there? The ball fake? Watch. You see how he motions the ball this way? What does that do right there? What does that motion do right there? These guys jump. Now watch the throw. There's a guy over top. So most quarterbacks, what they're trying to do is they're just trying to throw it long. You can't do that. What you have to do is you have to back shoulder. You slow him down, because if you put the ball out here, it's two things are going to happen. One, this wide receiver is going to get his ass cleaned. That sounded weird. His block knocked off. Or two, it's going to be an INT. But if you back shoulder it like it right here and make him stop, he can do one of two things. He's got at least 10 yards. Or if it's a decent, or you know, that's kind of like your guy, he could split the defender. But again, look at the throw, the awareness, the YOLO-ness right here, the pump fake, and then the throw of the back shoulder right in that hole, right in that sweet spot where only your wide receiver can catch it. You're throwing to grass. I mean, this was second and three, down 28-3 on your own 20. That takes balls right there. And the beautiful thing about this, if you go back and watch like the actual game, they interviewed Coach Leach on the sideline, and they're like, hey, what do you need to do? Because you're getting your ass kicked right now. And he goes, oh, we're not going to do anything. They can't stop us. The only thing that's stopping us is ourselves. I told our guys we need to calm down. We need to focus on what we're doing, and we need to go out and execute like we know that we can, because we're running essentially the same plays. He didn't say that. That's me saying it. But he said we need to execute. And what do? They went out there and executed. They ran their game plan. It's a thing of freaking beauty right there. And as you can tell, I am getting jacked up. All right. Let's see. Hey, QS, I love shallow cross on those third ones, fourth and ones. Yeah, something. Third down and fourth down and one. I understand. I'm guilty of this too. We have to fight that voice in our head as callers. It's like, hey, run the effing ball. You know, hey, we got to sack up and just run the ball. No, do something different. And go for it more often. Also, I mean, it's freaking, we need to do this. Now, this is my favorite play, and I know that all of y'all love this play. They scored on it. Mesh post, and here's the thing. Make a note of this, because they did this multiple times in a game. But mesh post, down on the goal line, they motioned this man in to get some motion. You know, you're setting up the same plays, but what the motion does is it gives the R, or the X or the Z, I can't remember, I'm stupid, on that side, on the right side, gives him some room to maneuver, and they're running the mesh post on this, which, I mean, guys, how can you not like it? So we got Ace motioning this guy in to run the mesh, so it's probably the Y's on the outside, motioning him in. Look, there's the motion right there, eyes out. They're only rushing, there's four guys in the red zone, or the green zone, what I call it, on the 5-yard line, 6-yard line. They're playing zone. Most teams play man-to-man down here, but Leach is so good at this. They know it's going to pass, and what happens? Keep your eyes up at the top of the screen. Boom. Boom. I'm going to fast forward a little bit. I want you to see what the motion does. The motion draws it. Look at that. Hey, what? Let me ask something. What does this look like that you do every single day? Every single day, watch his feet, watch his hands. What do air raid guys do every single day at practice to get great at this? It's foot fire. That's foot fire. Settle up and noose. That's what you're doing. That's that foot fire. Look what happened. Look at the defender's knees. It got him leaning to the one side, which opened up the inside where he wanted to go. If you want to go inside, you go. You fake outside. If you want to go outside, you fake inside. That created the separation. Right there. Boom. On mesh. Just because you run mesh does not mean you have to throw the mesh. But I want you to see what would happen if he did. Was it open or not? All right, so we're bringing him in motion again. Look, should have been a little bit closer. There's a hole right there. He could have thrown this. So he had a guy open here. He had a guy open here. If he takes him, he has a guy open here. All in his line of sight. And again, if y'all were so bored with this game, and I know that you watched the Michigan-Penn State game, what play did Michigan win? Mesh. When the chips were down, they went with mesh. You can talk about how everybody shits on mesh, but when they need a play, they dial up some form of mesh. So this is what happens right here, and it is unbelievable. All right? Down at the goal line, he's going to call some form of mesh, maybe some stick with the post over top, or maybe the corner. It's un-freaking believable, and you got to do it. A lot of us, when we get down there, we're like, we're going to have to run. We got to pound it. There's not enough space. There's not enough vertical space, but horizontally, there is. You just got to get creative. Corey called the fake key screen four times in a JV game, and it took the dang quarterback until the fourth time to realize I wanted him to throw the fade by number two. It happens. But I promise you, Corey, you call it again, or that same quarterback's moving up to varsity and you have that, all it takes is that one time for them to get it, and then that light bulb goes off. You just have to get them to understand it, and once they do, holy crap, it's going to be open all the time. All right? So the next one, I like this one. I'm sure you experts, Drew, if you're watching or listening later on, you know about this. He has a new formation. All right, it's kind of like a stack formation, an early stack where the slot is in front and the tight end is behind. They've run some runs out of it. I think it's his run set, but he runs the 95. But what I took away from this is the teaching aspect. If you listen to one of the clinics I did with Drew, he talks about how if it's man-to-man, if it's a man turn, you go 10 yards, you're running vertical, you're not dropping off. And then after about 10, the wide receiver turns and kind of looks at the quarterback to see if he's going to get it. And what you'll see from this is that is exactly what happens because they're on the same page. All right? So here's the formation. It's nasty. You got the H-back here. You got the slot right here. So it looks like 95 vertical. What I want you to see real quick is it 10 yards? So about right here, if y'all can see my – let me get my ugly freaking face out of the way. About right here is where he should be looking back, where he starts to look back because this is a zone turn. This is a man turn. Eyes on him, but – or I teach our kids dick to the sideline. His dick is to the sideline, so that's a man. Look right there, okay? You see his head? His head's turned. He's already knowing, hey, this guy's it's a man technique. I know he's going to be a back shoulder. It's unstoppable. It is unstoppable if you teach it this way. If your running backs and quarterbacks and wide receivers are all on the same page in this, and there's only one way that I know how you can get on this same page, and that is if you do pat and go. Every single day. Again, look at this. One-on-one, back shoulder, unguardable. You need to take those. You need to rep these. I have so many coaches reach out to me and go, hey, coach, how do you get good at this? You get good at this by running the same drills, running the same plays over and over again. It takes discipline to do that. And I'm saying that kind of pissed off at myself. It takes discipline to run the same plays over and over again because as coaches, we get this freaking thing. Again, it's that damn voice in the back of our head. This is boring. They're going to pick up on it. We have to do something new. The defensive coordinator is going to stop us. What if they do stop us? What plays do we have to counter out that? You have got to tell that voice to shut the hell up. And you've got to do the same thing over and over again. And the beautiful thing is, this works for any offense that you run. We are all guilty of putting in new shit every Saturday because that's what we think we need to do as coaches. And that could not be further from the truth. Look, it is 28-10 in this example right here, and they are still running their stuff. You didn't see Leach go 12 personnel and decide to run power. You didn't see Leach go and like flex bone or wing T or run buck sweep or anything like that. He was like, listen, guys, this is what we do. We do what we do, and we're doing this, and it worked. It comes back, okay? So that, again, those are the little teaching points that I got from this. Now, I know I could show every single touchdown, but this is the nitty-gritty stuff that I did, that I noticed watching this over and over and over again. And this is another one. Hey, be honest. First off, if you're getting anything from this, please give me a thumbs up. It tells the YouTube algorithm that you like this. And also, to me, the thumbs up is the middle finger to X and O Digital, whatever their service name is, because I know I'm going to get a copyright strike. But let's say you have a formation called, right? You get a timeout or you get a penalty. How many of you actually run the same formation that you were in? Huh? I know I'm guilty of it. I've done it from time to time, but not Coach Leach. I want to show this. This isn't a play or anything, but I want you to notice this, okay? Third and two. They're in an ace formation right now. There's a penalty coming up. How many of y'all run the same formation, maybe the same play? Not Coach Leach. What does he do? He goes back to 3-by-1. He changes it up because you're giving the defense a lot of credit and help if you stay in the same formation on a dead ball and a timeout or a penalty, something like that. You've got to change the freaking presentation and do something different. And this is just, again, look at this, the motion. I don't even know if he completed this right now, probably, because it's the freaking air raid. But look at the motion. So if we go back to the previous one, No motion, no nothing, right? Ace, no motion, no nothing. Look like the screen and go again. So he changes it up. Now this time, runs motion right here. What does that do to the linebackers? It affects this one right here and this one right here. Their eyes are pulled. That pries open the middle of the field right here. And if you want to know, what does this look like? This looks like the very first play I covered. There's the hitch. Here's the switch concept. Coach Leach, down 28-17, called the same exact play that he called on 4th-and-1. This time they went to a different person. You don't have to have 1,000 different plays. You don't. You just have to run a couple of them good. And he went back to the same. If you don't believe me, again, take a mental picture. Late. He's running. Motion. There's the sit right there. Here's the switch right there. Okay. You see that, right? We're going to go back to the very first slide. Very first one. Ballsy. Ballsy play call. What do we have? Late. Same thing. Motion. Opposite. Boom. He hits this one. He's calling the same plays because he believes in the system over and over and over again. A lot of us don't. We say that we do. We say that we have a system, but we don't have a system. Coach Leach does. That's why he's been great everywhere. The piss on the record, all of y'all. I mean, seriously, they just got ranked again. They're after this, they're in the same they have the same record as Auburn after this game. But you don't see anybody saying that. No, and I'm sorry. If he stays there, he's going to have a lot of success, especially running this over and over and over again. All right? But the takeaway, run the same play. Change it up on dead balls. I mean, sometimes we make things way too simple for the defense. Now, guys, seriously, on that note, where I'm there, guess what? He calls the same exact mesh play with the same motion again, because if it works, don't fix it, you know? I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Look, same thing, same motion. Bring him in motion. What does that do? It loosens him up. It opens up the post that he hits. The same play. He learned the last time, oh, we can't go man-to-man down here and match up. We're going to have to do some kind of zone call. So what's that do? Loosens him up. You have the mesh right here. Shitty mesh. Doesn't matter. You still hit the post on the back. It is unbelievable how simple he really is, but he doesn't. Guys, we make things more difficult than they need to be. All right? You need to have a system. You need to have something in place where you freaking want to just do this. Okay? And this kind of segues into what I'm putting on Stan Bedwell, Coach Hal Mummy's right-hand man. We are going to be doing a mini workshop this Sunday, okay? There's only a couple of seats left, and you can get in right here. And I just wanted to show you real quick, before I get to the questions, put them in the comments, what we're going to be covering in this, okay? And I'm freaking thrilled to cover this with Coach Bedwell, all right? Well, shit. I clicked on something and didn't do it. All right, here we go. So this is what we're working on, guys. He's going to be talking about Friday. It's his simple, quick game system that he came up there with Coach Hal Mummy. He's going to be talking about Friday. What did he do? What is it? He's got cut-ups. You will get cut-ups, access to these cut-ups and everything after it's over with. All right? He's going to be talking about 61-62 hitch, which, again, is if you follow the air raid, it is a huge thing of the air raid, what you do in the quick game. That is your run game right now. Okay? And he's also going to cover, look, he just got done visiting with Coach Hal Mummy. And he's going to be talking about that in this mini workshop. You can go, that's down in the description, click it. It's right here, thefootballsecrets.com, simple, quick game system. He's going over it all, no stone unturned, and he's answering any and every one of your freaking questions. I can't wait, man. I can't wait at all. And let's see what's going on, guys. All right. Oh, we already got that. Let's see. Bradley, I love to use bunch formations in the red zone, short yardage. Yeah, I agree. Bunch is really nice. If you go back and look, I have a short somewhere on this video where Miami uses bunch with a motion, and that causes a confusion with the defense because they don't talk. You know, usually when you got 3-by-1 right here, this one guy is man-to-man with the corner. When you motion someone, that corner's got to do something. And in that Miami example, he didn't at all. It was nice. Andrew, hey, Coach, I know this isn't the topic of the video, but have you seen the LA Rams run mesh out of 4x1? Play worked beautifully and got them a touchdown. Yeah, because it's mesh. A lot of people like to poop on it because, you know, the air raid kind of talked about it all the time. But mesh is mesh. You need to have mesh in there. It's unbelievable. All right, Zachary, air raid concepts are gold. Air raid gets a bad rap for being soft and a finesse offense. The air raid is so multiple and truly allows freedom and flexibility. Spin it to win it. I agree. I think in the age of the internet where everybody is going to the spread, you see it on the internet, you see it in games and everything like that, throwing the ball. There's always going to be that group of coaches that want to run. Hey, that's fine. Do it. But the air raid is so simple. Like, it's so simple. A lot of people, and I've combated this over and over again from different people, they see the pass as soft. They need to get over it. This is the 21st century or 22nd century. I don't even know. I'm an idiot. But you need to pass. You need to pass the ball. Look at all the explosive offenses in both college, at the collegiate level, and at the NFL level. And hell, probably, I know someone's going to be like, well, there's a wing T guy that's scoring this. Yeah. Okay, great. You can show one example. But a lot of the explosive offenses that are exciting and everything, they throw the ball, they get the kids out there. You need to throw the ball, and the air raid is the easiest way to do that. Corey, always change when they call a timeout. Got to. All right. QS almost always able to get opposing coaches here in Nebraska to call timeout when we're in the 5 wide receiver set. Spread isn't common here, and I love to be different and mess with the old school running teams. I agree. I mean, that's nice, especially if you got 5 wide. 5 wide, this is something that a lot of people don't understand. 5 wide, okay, with a running quarterback, nasty. Ask any defensive coordinator. That makes them piss themselves that week because they can't do that. All right. What are your recommendations? Good Lord, let me take a sip of water. For system on air raid, Mummy, Franklin. If you want to go the true, it's the Mummy. Yeah, to me, Mummies is the purest form. I mean, it tells you exactly what it is. Franklin, the last I saw, I've maybe 2-3 years ago, it's just like a bunch of stuff that you get to pick and choose which one you want. Hal's stuff is freaking, here's the offense. I created it. Here's the offense. And I can't say enough good things about it. What was the most productive play this year, Coach? I know you wanted to share it with us. For us, honestly, it was either 95 or counter. I freaking love counter. I love it. Did I say that right? Hey, Coach, would you consider zone run in the goal? Yeah, I do. I mean, if you go back and look a lot, unless you're in like some kind of gold line formation or something like that, a lot of the plays are inside zone or something like that. And especially if you have a quarterback that knows how to read the end, because, you know, usually that end is going to crash right there and he can pull it. That is a nice play to have on the goal line. All right. Knuck if you buck. Hey, man, whatever floats your boat, buddy. Alex, just got offered the CB coach job in my high school. Well, first off, congratulations, man. Congrats. High fives and butt slaps. Any drills you know of that can help CB development? I don't, but if you go on Twitter, let me find out. I'll drop it in chat. Hold on. Match. Coverage. Cody Alexander. That's the guy. That's the cornerback guy. I'm going to drop this in the chat. All right. Follow him. He's got so much good stuff out there. Again, freaking congrats, dude. And that's the guy I would follow if I was on the defensive side of the ball in the secondary. All right, Colby, do you think Leach is the best offensive coach in college football? Nothing else, he's up there. He's got to be on the Mount Rushmore. I know he gets a lot of crap. Look, he's weird. I'm going to be honest. As coaches, as people, we kind of got to separate the art from the artist. I know that's very difficult, okay? There's some coaches that we don't align with philosophically, personally, anything like that. Same thing with musicians and movies and directors and authors and everything like that. But to me, if I'm just focusing in on football, his offense is amazing. It's right up there with Paul Johnson. With Paul Johnson, it is. Because just how pure they are and that they haven't deviated. They dive into what they do. You know, I mean, Paul Johnson's not doing the kind of the stuff that Navy and Army and all them, you know, kind of branched off to. He was like, nope, flex bone, this is what I'm doing. Same thing with Leach. He doesn't branch from anything. It is it's unbelievable. Willie, hey, Coach, can you draw up your count? Hey, Willie, 2, maybe 3 videos. Go back. I did a whole thing on counter. Go and look at on my channel, and it's all right there. Justin, Coach Mackey loves the wing tee. it's a fun offense. I mean, when it's working, but if I gun to my head, no, air raid. Can we rewatch the Zoom after one? Yes, talking about the mini workshop. Yeah, you book your seat. You've got lifetime access to the mini workshop and everything like that. Yeah, all the cut-ups, the bonus material, all of that. You get lifetime access forever and ever. Coach Thomas, Coach Bowden, and Coach Rodriguez came down to New Orleans and went undefeated in 1998 and changed high school football forever in Louisiana. Yeah, I completely agree with the zone read. That's the craziest story, man, Coach Rich Rod pulling that, where the quarterback just was like, hey, what if I pulled this? And then it happened. It was like, hey, what'd you do? Like, I just pulled it. And he was like, I like that. Let's keep it in. QS, yes. I cannot wait for the Egg Bowl. Hey, I'm stuck in South Carolina, so I really don't care about Clemson or Carolina at all. That's the game I'm looking for. Screw the Iron Bowl. Screw all that. The Egg Bowl is where it's at, and I cannot wait. Can't confirm as a D coach, running QB and five wide set is a cheat code. Thank you, Casey. Thank you. A lot of people think I'm stupid when I say that. It's not. And you don't even need to run the quarterback like every play. Just sprinkle them in. Every couple of plays, just sprinkle them in and then keep your same stuff. Unbelievable. Thoughts on speed option as a foundational bread? I'm going to be honest. I know jack shit about this speed option. I like it when it works. I hate it when it doesn't. Never called it. Never ran it. I'm the wrong guy to do that. All right, Coach McDaniel, what are we talking about? Wishbone Stewart? I might be in the wrong room. The air raid. The air raid. I hate you, Coach. I love you, but I hate you. All right, let's see. Zachary, Coach, what is the philosophical differences between Art Briles, Veer and Shoot, and Mike Leach's air raid? Honestly, and you can talk to – I've talked to a lot of Baylor guys. Excuse me. The Veer and Shoot, it's not that, man. It really was inside zone power counter. More inside zone and power, and then just option routes. That was it. They didn't run Veer at all. I mean, at all. Leach throws the ball all the time. Briles, I'm guessing about 90% of the time, if he had to choose, he wanted to run the ball. That's why they use the big splits and all everything like that. The two offenses are not the same. Nate, Coach, would you hire Kendall from Big Time Rush High School as an O coordinator? He runs a wing T. I don't know who that is. I feel like you put me on the spot. Yes, let's just go ahead and say that. Okay. All right. Coaches, I appreciate it. Hey, check the link. I'm serious. We're diving deep. There it is right there. It's in the description. I appreciate you being here so much. And until next time, let's continue to mash the spread, score points, and have fun. And hey, XO Digital, if you're hearing this, I hate you, and I hope you poop the bed. I'll talk to y'all later.